Well, it's time for some bring it on questions, and we're going to turn the tables on Christy and ask her. So she's going to be the expert today. Here we go. My kids are in elementary school and love to play with the kids next door. The neighborhood kids are ignored by their parents or poorly behaved, and I don't want my kids to pick up their bad habits. Do I expose my kids to this or protect them from it?
You know, I think as parents, Gordon, so oftentimes we want to protect our kids and shield them. And in the process of doing that, we're not really showing the love of the Lord to those kids. If those kids are obviously neglected and they're behaving poorly, it's because there's no one there to kind of teach them how not to behave, you know, how to behave wonderfully. So I would embrace those kids. If they're going to play with your kids, say, come on, let's play together. And when they do kind of behave badly, you know, it's the art of distraction. I love the art of distraction and say, you know, maybe they're doing something. You can say, well, what do you need? What do you want? And just to kind of love them. And it's interesting.
So you bring them into your home.
I wouldn't bring them into my home, but I would bring them. Well, because I don't bring kids in my home. But I would bring, like, for instance, I'll give you a perfect example. Not too long ago. Yeah.
Write her on that.
Not too long ago, my son was outside. Oh, well, yeah, but you've got to, anyway.
You got to provide snacks and all that kind of
stuff. Well, yeah, I do that. But, like, not too long ago, my son was out, and there were these new kids that were around the neighborhood. And so they were just kind of, like, walking the street, and I would just see them walking. And I said, well, why don't you come over and play? I said, Chase, why don't you ask them? So they all start playing. So I went inside, and I got bubbles, and I got candy, and I got all this stuff, and water balloons. And
candy?
I played with them. Yeah, candy.
It's not allowed on Skinny Wednesday.
It ain't Wednesday. It's Thursday. Now
to
it's
their
funny.
Parents, now you're giving them candy.
They're happy. So now the kids always come and ring the doorbell because you showed them the love.
Okay.
Did I answer the question?
You did.
All right, good.
You did. Show the love.
Show the love.
Yeah, that would be the, yeah.
Okay.
I'd check that one. Go, yeah.
I think that's good. Okay, now it's your turn.
All right, my turn.
You ready? Cheryl Lynn writes in. She says, I made a new friend at a community college where I attend. He's a Buddhist and says he would like to learn more about Christian beliefs. I invited him to come to church with me, but he says he's only going to come and agree to go if I go to his temple. What do you think?
Wow. Well, you get the kid question. I get the Buddhist question.
I know, right?
I myself have gone to Buddhist temples in an effort to learn more about Buddhism because... I was tasked with trying to evangelize parts of the Buddhist world, Thailand and Vietnam and China and Burma, and I wanted to learn about it. It wasn't with a specific individual. You know, when I started telling other Christians I was doing that, I learned about Hinduism, learned about Islam, all because I just really felt it was a call. And I found evidence where the Apostle Paul had tried to learn. He was raised Jewish, and he was trying to learn the local religions of the cities that he was evangelizing. And he even talks about going around and considering their objects of worship in Acts chapter 17. So I took that as inspiration and did that. And learned a fair amount. Now, when I talked to other Christians about it, they were going, oh, no, your mind's been polluted by these other thoughts. And I'm going, no, it's not. You know, the more I found out, the more grateful I was for the message of the gospel, because I learned something real critical, and that all these other religions, I don't care which ones you name, it's all about how can you perfect yourself? Mm-hmm. How can you get to a point where you can finally come into nirvana or moksha or... you know, have entry into heaven, and it's all about that. And with that comes this whole slavery to it, where if you don't bow down to the idol and you don't offer sacrifice, then the demons are going to come and get you. But here was Christianity, and Christianity said, God's going to do all that for you. God's going to come down from heaven. You don't have to make yourself perfect to get to heaven. He's going to come down to you right where you are, and he's going to be with you. And he's never going to leave you or forsake you. He's going to forgive everything you've ever done wrong because he loves you so much. And it's the love of God that brings us to repentance. With the Buddhists, their first noble truth is all existence is suffering. Life is suffering. That's the first thing they teach people. And I just scratch my head and go, no, life is wonderful. And when you hear the words of Jesus, I came that you might have life and have it more abundantly. The contrast will be obvious, but get yourself geared up. But I encourage you get to know these others, and in that whole process, you'll become very grateful for what Jesus Christ did.
Good answer. And you didn't even need my help. I'm kidding, Gordon. I'm kidding. Listen, if you want to ask Gordon even more questions, remember, you can always log on to CBN.com.
Or Christy.
Log on to CBN.com, and it's a great place where CBN.com is awesome anyways, but you can always check out some more Bring It On questions.